So we have the governing equations for this coupled oscillator problem. Let's try and solve them. This is different than the first order system we've been solving because this is a second order system, but the solution method is very similar. So we're going to try an ansatz here. We're going to try our x, which is a column vector, x1, x2. So this is a function of time. And we're going to set this equal to a constant vector times e to the rt. Okay, so that's the same ansatz we used previously. What happens when we substitute in now? We have the second derivative. That will bring down an r squared, right? The first derivative brings down an r, the second an r squared. So we'll end up with mr squared times v times the exponential function, which we're going to end up canceling. And that's going to be equal to this matrix, which I'll call A, times v. Okay, and the exponential function cancels. This is, you should recognize this as an eigenvalue problem. This is AV equals lambda V. And here, the eigenvalue is our MR squared. Okay, so we've reduced the mathematical solution of this equation to an eigenvalue problem. We need to find then this is a 2x2 matrix, so we're going to need to find two eigenvalues, lambda, and the two eigenvectors, v. And then using lambda equals mr squared, we're going to solve for each lambda, we're going to find two values of r. And those are the values that go in this exponential function here. And we're going to have two eigenvectors. So we'll have, for each value of v, we'll have two values of r. We'll have to see how that works. It's a bit different for the second order equation than for the first order equation. So our first task here in this video is to find the eigenvalues lambda. So we have, let me separate here. We have to do the characteristic equation. So we have the determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0, our characteristic equation. This is our A. So we subtract lambda from the diagonal and then take the determinant. The two diagonal terms are the same, and we'll end up with little k plus big K plus lambda squared minus big K squared equal to 0. So this all is going to be equal to big K. Okay, and that's the characteristic equation. Big K squared, right? So we have the diagonal element minus big K times big K equals 0. So on the right-hand side, we have a big K squared. Take the square root. So we have a little k plus big K plus lambda equal to plus or minus big K. And then we want to solve this for lambda. So we have two lambdas here. We add minus k minus big K to both sides. So we have a lambda 1, which is going to be minus little k minus big K plus big K. So that's just a minus little k. And we have a lambda 2, which is minus little k minus big K minus big K. So minus little k plus 2 big K. Okay, so those are our two eigenvalues. of this AV equals lambda V problem. What we want are the two values of R, which go in this exponential here. So R is plus or minus the square root of lambda divided by M. So for instance, let me write down R1 then. R1 is going to be equal to, there are two of them, right, from here. So lambda over M, and then plus or minus. So plus or minus the square root of lambda 1 over M, which is minus little k over M, which is plus or minus I, the imaginary number, times root little k over M. Okay? That's the R1 associated with lambda 1. The R2 will be plus or minus the square root of negative little k plus 2 big K over M, which will be plus or minus I times root little k plus 2 big K over M. Okay? Those are our R1s and R2s. So how is the solution going to work? For R1, for these two values of R1, we're going to have one eigenvector of V1. And then for R2, these two values of R2, we'll have another eigenvector, which is V2. So because these are complex numbers, we're going to have to use the principle of superposition to construct real functions here. V will be real, so what will happen is that we'll have a V1, and then we'll have a e to the I root k over m t, and an e to the minus I root k over m t, and we can add them and subtract them, and what we'll end up with a cosine root k over m t and a sine root k over m t. So what we usually do is that those arguments of the cosine and sine are our frequencies. And this eigenvalue analysis gave us two frequencies. So I'll write the frequencies here. We'll have an omega 1 frequency, which is going to be the square root of little k over m. And we'll have an omega 2 frequency, which will be the square root of little k plus 2 big K over M. Okay? We'll understand this problem in terms of these two frequencies. Okay, what remains to be done now is to compute the eigenvectors and then to understand the physical significance of those eigenvectors. Let me summarize. We're solving the coupled oscillator problem. We came up with the governing differential equation in the last video. We're going to solve that the way we've always solved this type of system of linear equations. We're going to use an ansatz where this column vector x is going to be equal to a constant vector v times e to the rt. After substituting in, we get an eigenvalue problem, AV equals lambda V, where lambda is related to this R by lambda equals MR squared. From the characteristic equation, we get two values of lambda, lambda 1 and lambda 2. From lambda 1 and lambda 2, we get four values of R, but R1 is just I root k over M and its complex conjugate. R2 is just I root k plus 2 big K over M and its complex conjugate. If we use the principle of superposition on our x, since we have complex exponentials, that can be, and they're purely imaginary, that can be converted into sines and cosines. And the frequencies of the sines and cosines are given by omega 1 and omega 2. We'll continue this solution in the next video, and we'll compute the eigenvectors. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.